Now let's look at SR latch with enable input. This enable input is going to control when this S and R input is going to affect the memory components. And as you can see, this is not an active low input circuit. This is an active high input circuit. Okay. So when that means that when S is equal to 1, we are going to set Q is equal to 1 with R is equal to 0. Okay, when S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0, we are going to set the circuit. That means Q becomes 1 and Q bar becomes 0. And when we wanted to reset the circuit, R input should be 1 and S input should be 0. At that time, Q will become 0 and Q bar will become 1. Now let's see how this enable signal is going to control when this S and R should affect this memory component. So when enable is 0, irrespective of the value of S and R, what will be the output here? We have 0 here and 0 here. Even if this S is 1, 1 and 0 is going to be 0 and not of 0 is going to be 1 here. And similarly, irrespective of the value of R, the output of this NAND gate is going to be 1 here. When you have a 1 and 1, this is a cross-coupled NAND gate implementation of the SR latch. Okay, so when you have 1 and 1 as input, we are going to retain the state. That's what we have seen here. Okay, so the circuit, this circuit is available here. Okay, so the operation of this cross-coupled NAND gate is going to be very similar to this operation. So when you have 1 and 1, you are going to retain no change state. Okay, so that is what we write it here as no change. So irrespective of the input S and R, when enable is 0, there will not be any change in the value of Q and Q bar. Now let's see what happens when enable is 1. When enable is 1, let's see, when S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, what happens? Assume that initially Q is 0 and Q bar is 1. Now when S is equal to 0, when S is equal to 1, we actually wanted to change this Q to 1 from 0. Let's see how this happens. Okay, now since enable is 1, this line becomes 1, this line becomes 1. So we get 1, sorry, when 1 and 1 is 1, not of 1 is going to be 0. So this line is going to be 0 and this line 1 and 0 is going to be 0, 0, not of 0 is going to be 1. So this line is going to be 1. So when you get the input 0 and 1, okay, what happens? You are going to, when you have 0, 1, you are going to have the output Q is equal to 1, Q bar is equal to 0. Let's work out here as well. So this line is 0, this line is 1, and therefore 1 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1, and this 1 comes here. 1 and 1 is 1, not of 1 is going to be 0, this 0 is going to be supplied here, 0 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1, and this is already 1, so this output will remain as 0. And we can see that the output is stabilized and Q has become 1. Now if we remove the input, that means that if we change this S to 0 from 1, so 1 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1 here, and here enable is 1 and R is still 0, and therefore the output here is 1. And we know that when we have 1 and 1, this is going to be the retained state for this cross coupled SR latch. Let's see how it works. So when you have 1 here, you have a 0 here, 1 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1, that 1 is coming here, 1 and 1 is 1, not of 1 is going to be 0, and that is what we have here already in the circuit. That means that the state of the circuit is not affected even though we have changed the input. That means that we have retained the state. So when you give the input 0 and 0 for S and R, the previous state is going to be maintained. And we have seen when S is set to 1, Q will be set to 1 and Q bar will be becoming 0. Now let's see what happens when R becomes 1. When R becomes 1, 1 and 1 is 1, not of 1 is going to be 0. And here the output is going to be 1 because we haven't changed this S value. So it is 0, enable is 1. So the output here is going to be 1. Now you get a 0 here. So 0 and 1 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1. And that 1 will be supplied here. 1 and 1 is 1, not of 1 is going to be 0. That 0 will be supplied here. 0 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1. And this input is retained. So you can see that when R becomes 1, Q bar becomes 1 and Q becomes 0. That is, we are resetting the circuit. Similarly, when we remove the input R to 0, this output will become 1 and this output is 1 already. So 1 and 1 will retain the information, and it is forbidden to give both S and R to be 1 at the same time. Let's see why. When enable is 1 and when we set both S and R to be 1, okay, we get a 1 and 1 is 1, not of 1 is going to be 0 here, and similarly the output here will be 0 and you supply a 0 here, 0 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1, you get a 1 here, 1 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1 here, you are going to supply that 1 here. Again, 1 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1. You can see that both Q and Q bar becomes 1, which is not acceptable because Q and Q bar are complement to each other. Therefore, we are forbidden to give this input 1 and 1 when enable is 1.